So let us start with today's topic, that is optical rotation. Here we are going to talk about the Fresnel's explanation of theory of optical rotation. Optical rotation means when the state of polarization changes for a linearly polarized light, when light passes from a length of optically active medium. So last time we talked about what is levorotatory, dextrorotatory, that is clockwise, anti-clockwise, and so on. So here we are going to talk about the Fresnel's explanation. And Fresnel concluded that optical rotation inside a medium is nothing but can simply be explained as a plane polarized light when enter into an optical active medium, it is split up into two oppositely directed circularly polarized light. So you can say that we can say linear vibration is equivalent to RCP plus LCP. This is the basic idea of Fresnel theory of optical rotation. That means if I am having a linear vibration or plane polarized light which enters into optically active medium, it split itself into right circularly polarized light and left circularly polarized light. So this we discussed the other day that if the nature is clockwise, it is called as derotatory, where the plane of polarization rotates towards the clockwise direction. And if it is L rotatory, that is the levorotatory, the plane of polarization will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. So same is true for material possessing this property also. So if we are having a dextrorotatory material, in that case RCP will travel faster as compared to LCP, and in levorotatory material LCP will have a faster speed as compared to RCP. So now you can divide optically active material into two categories. Optically active medium, one can be, or talking in terms of RLN only, if the material is L-type, in that case, RCP component will be faster. And if it is L-type, in that case, LCP component would be faster. Than the other one. So now let us try and justify the situation that how the explanation is true that when we combine LCP and RCP vibration, what we get should be a linear vibration. So let me write a linear vibration. So our statement here would be a linear vibration may be considered as equivalent to two oppositely directed circular vibrations. So this is the statement that we are trying to make with this. Now let us look at its justification. Let us take one vibration which is given by, we have x as 0 and y as a cos omega t, where our angular frequency is omega, hence the frequency of vibration would be omega by 2 pi. Now x is 0 and y is given by a cos omega t. So it's a sinusoidal vibration. The same thing I can rewrite as, so this is a linear vibration because it is only vibrating along y-axis. So this I can write as 1 by 2 a sin omega t minus 1 by 2 a sin omega t, which makes x component as 0, and y component I can write 1 by 2 a cos omega t plus 1 by 2 a cos omega t, which is equal to again a cos omega t. So with this representation, I can write x in the form of x1 plus x2, and y I am rewriting as y1 plus y2. Now, since this was our linear vibration, this is linear, we are trying to write it in such a form that it is seen as a combination of two circularly polarized lights. So the resultant we can write as x1. So my x1 is 1 by 2 a sin omega t, and y1 is 1 by 2 a cos omega t. X2 we defined as minus 1 by 2 a sin omega t, and y2 as 1 by 2 a cos omega t. So now looking at these two equations, you can tell one will give rise to RCP and other will give rise to LCP. So as it is visible, this first set of vibrations, as x1 is in the positive sign direction, it will give rise to the clockwise one, that is RCP. And for x2 one, here we have x direction as negative, hence it will be LCP. So we have successfully written linear vibration in the formation of combination of RCP and LCP. So let's say I'm talking about these vibrations, and I have one x component and one y component. So here, instead of that, we are going to talk in terms of LCP and RCP. So let's say this is my effective state of polarization for linearly polarized light. Then this direction would be for, or let me choose another color. This direction would be for LCP, and this vibration would be for RCP. So this vector is going to keep on going in the left direction, and this vector will keep on going in this direction. So this is your anti-clockwise, this is your clockwise. But as both are moving with the same speed, at whatever location they go, their resultant will always be in this direction. So let's say if both of them move little past here and here, resultant would still remain the same. If we flip this and they come on the different side, in that case, this is my center. So let's say this is R vibration, that is, which is going clockwise, and this is L vibration, which is going anti-clockwise. So this is L. Hence, the resultant of both would still give me linearly polarized light. So as long as both of them are having no phase difference and same frequency, the combination of LCP and RCP will keep on giving you linearly polarized excuse me, linearly polarized light. So to summarize again, Fresnel's idea was that a linear vibration, when it travels inside optically active medium, it splits up into two components known as RCP and LCP, and LR type of component allows R to be faster as compared to L and vice versa. So when it moves through that, what happens is extra phase difference is introduced, because now R and L keeps on moving with different speed with respect to each other. And because still both are LCP and RCP, but now with a different phase difference, they come out in a state of polarization, which is now shifted with respect to the first one. If there is no phase difference, so as you see from here, your state of polarization will not change. If my state of polarization was along this direction, then no matter what is the location of LCP or RCP effective curve, this will not change. But if one is having some delta which is other than the LCP, or one is moving faster than the other, then the both location will become non-different, and now the effective E will start to change. So let us see that how. This is also called as Fresnel's explanation of optical rotation. Both the same thing. So we have a first point that a linearly polarized light split up into, when it goes into optically active medium, it split up into RCP and LCP. And again, when it comes out, it becomes linearly polarized light. So it is important to remember that whatever is happening, the conversion of LCP to RCP, these are circularly polarized light only inside the medium. Before entering, it was linearly polarized. Coming out also, it is always linearly polarized. Second point, these two, RCP and LCP, move with same speed when they are inside optically inactive medium. Optically inactive medium. When they are inside optically active medium, if you are in R type of medium, or you can say derotatory medium, inside a derotatory medium, clockwise moves faster, that is RCP is faster and L rotatory medium, LCP moves fast. And last, on emergence, RCP and LCP combine to give linearly polarized light, which is rotated by some angle, which is rotated related to or relative to incident beam. So if the material is RCP, in that case, the rotation will happen along clockwise direction. If material is L rotatory, then that will happen along left hand side. So relative to original incident vibration. So let us take one example for that also. So now let's say our material is clockwise. How we wrote x equal to x1 plus x2. So now in writing the same thing, and we wrote y1 as y1 plus y2, where our x1 plus was 1 by 2 sine omega t, x2 was minus 1 by 2 sine omega t, and same thing as cos component for y1 and y2. But now we are saying that our material is such that now RCP component moves faster. Moves faster. So now there will be extra phase difference introduced between the two. So as you remember, RCP was because of the combination of x1 plus y1. Hence, now we will rewrite x1 as 1 by 2 a sine omega t plus delta and y1 as 1 by 2 a cos omega t plus delta and our anti-clockwise component, LCP component, will now move with the same speed. So we'll move with same speed, the speed with which it entered into the system. So that can be written as previously what we considered as minus 1 by 2 sine of omega t and y2 as 1 by 2. I missed a over here, sorry. 1 by 2 a cos omega t. So now as you can see, we have introduced a factor of extra phase difference, that is delta between the two. So this one is RCP, which is now having extra delta as compared to the LCP component. So now what will happen? Let us have the same diagram that we were drawing for the combination. So now let us consider two cases. First as the incident one and the second one as when it passes through the optically active medium. So you can say this is input and this is output. So for the first one, say this is, so this is our L component, this is our R component, but both combined will give us a state of polarization. So this was our effective incident beam. When it enters inside the optically active medium, RCP is having extra phase difference. So let's say while coming out, this is the position of L just before coming out inside the medium. So when it has covered the complete length of the crystal and we have this as R, so now R and L will differ by some delta and the effective difference between the two would be, so this phase difference would be delta by 2 with which our plane of vibration will be rotated. So initial one was over here and the final one is now rotated by delta by 2. So that is the meaning of optically active medium. When a plane polarized light passes through, output is also plane vibration but is rotated clockwise. So now we know the reason why both of them split up into circularly polarized light of reverse direction, one being LCP, other being RCP. Depends on the material which one will move faster. Fresnel also did one demonstration with the experimental idea in order to demonstrate that this really happens. For this, it is important to know that quartz prisms were used in this experiment, and these quartz crystals or prisms are very different than the one that is used for creating double refraction. As we discussed previously, that in order to observe double refraction, we make use of quartz prism. But in those cases, we use quartz prism in such a manner that light is incident normally to optic axis. But here, when we want to create the optically active medium such that we will be able to split up RCP and LCP, that side, we use quartz in such a manner that our light is going parallel to optically active medium. So quartz behaves as optically active medium when light is passing parallel to optic axis. So this is a special quartz. So you have quartz when your optic axis, you are passing the light parallel to it. In that case, it will be optically active. And when optic axis is perpendicular to incident beam, that time it would be inactive. So when we do the experiment for getting the double refraction through quartz prism, that time our angle of incidence is such that, or the plane of incidence is such that, optic axis is always perpendicular. So that time it is inactive. Now we are using the same quartz crystal, but such that optic axis is parallel. The one in which there is no separation in E ray and O ray that way. So this is again another quality of crystal that we use. So now we are going to look at the assembly which is used for demonstration of Fresnel's idea. So this is the experimental arrangement suggested by Fresnel. It is in such a manner that our optic axis is here and these are alternate. So one is right and right type, and these are two are L type. So what happens when light is incident onto it? When light enters into this at normal incidence angle, let's say you have a L substance, then you have L prism and R prism. So R prism and L prism. So you can say that L prism will act as a denser medium for R component. So if we have L prism, then in L prism, left component will move faster and hence R component will move slower. So whichever moves slower, for that refractive index will be more. The meaning of more refractive index is the bending of light would be more. Hence, you will have R component bending more as compared to L component. Then when we reach into R, now for R, for L component, R prism will act as a denser one. So this will even bend more. This will go as it is. When you enter into L, now again, R will bend more. This will go as it is, and so on. So this alternate R and L assembly will serve the purpose of separating out L component and R component. And when at the output, if you check the state of polarization of both of these, this one is left and this one is right. Okay, so this one is the explanation of the idea of Fresnel demonstration of proving that actually this is a linearly polarized light, and when it enters into this optically active substance, it bifurcates into two circularly polarized lights, and with this kind of assembly we can actually separate them out. So to summarize, you have to remember you have R prism which will serve as denser medium for L component. So it is the other way round. Let me rewrite it. R prism will serve as a denser medium for L component, and L prism will serve as denser medium for R component. Hence, when light enters into, first it is going undeviated till here, hardly any change separation will occur because this thickness ideally is actually very small. Then when it enters into L, because it is a L type prism, R would bend more. This one is R type, so L would bend more. This is again L type, so R would bend more. And then for the last one also, L would bend more. And these two, if you observe, you know how to check the state of polarization of L and R using the quarter wave plate. So using this, you can experimentally verify that this is right circularly polarized light and this one is left circularly polarized light. Okay, that's it. Thank you.